Can you repeat the question?
हाँ, क्योंकि वो आ ही जाएगा.
The catch is to look at your camera.
My elder one, very specifically, she is not a very bold person, but of late I have noticed that she talks back. So I tell her, you don't start something, but yes, you give it back when required. And the younger one is a little bubbly, so I always tell her that don't worry, do what you want, but don't hit someone. That's all what I always tell her.
Taking the first question, try and instill a value of respecting your own wishes and standing up for oneself. If he feels that he's right, he should not be giving in. In case it gets a bit serious, I have told him that he can go up to his teachers or to his parents or anybody in the safe circle if it gets out of hand. But first he has to try to handle it at his hand. With regards to bullying, I have actively spoken to him on respecting every individual, not even individual, but you know, every living person, or even like your furry friends, and you know, everybody. So, and you shouldn't be forcing anybody if they don't feel like doing it, which applies to him also, that nobody will be forcing you. If you don't like being forced, then you shouldn't be forcing anybody to, you know, for anything.
There's no way you can ensure that. But what I had done was, when my child was in junior KG, she used to often get, you know, bullied by somebody, or someone's hitting her, or someone's doing that. So I used to be like, okay, Cheshu, if somebody says something to you or does something, you have to firmly say no, back off. If they don't listen, they still go on about it, you have to tell them, don't do it, or whatever, or tell the parent there, or the teacher, or whoever's around. If they still don't do it, you come and tell me, or you tell somebody. And if they still don't listen and they still keep hitting you, you please get up and hit them. I mean, I don't want you, after 4-5 times, I don't want you sitting and, you know, being bullied like that. Somehow these kids got amnesia in the initial bit, and she remembered the hit bit. So it was 1 year, it was like somebody says anything, does anything, fuck, they used to get it. I guess over a period of time, once they develop bonding with their friends, their, you know, the people around, the peer group, it's calm. Then they learn to balance it eventually. I guess how you behave at home, what you do at home, eventually plays. So they learn to balance their thing and they take their call on their own. So they don't bully, they don't get bullied either. So.
I constantly talk to him whenever he comes from school. I always talk to him that, you know, what has happened in the school, what did you do in the school, whom did you sit with school, what did you eat. So by his answer only, I am able to judge that he is not bullying anyone and he is not being bullied also.
I actually talk very freely to him and ask him every time. If he's upset, then also I ask him if something has went wrong with him or not.
Yes, that's very important. Like I said, that there's a lot of things that children learn from the outside apart from what they're learning at home. And us being a very socially aware and exposed to social media society, it's very important that I keep a trap on what my children are listening, hearing, seeing. It's very important.
I feel it's extremely important, more than academics at this age, because they learn more from their parents, their peers, and the environment that they are in currently. So I keep a very close watch on who his friends are, or whom he likes, or what does he like about them. Because ultimately, that is what he's going to pick up, good or bad.
Of course, that is very, very important. And I don't think so right now, at his age, it is not very important, because every child is almost similar. But yes, at the later stage, when the child grows up, it is very, very important that you, you know, analyze his company. So it is very important.
Kind of, yes, for awareness, to know who's good, to know who's bad, to know where they are going to be, to know where I find them. They are at an age where I'm not necessarily with them right now. So I have to know where to find them first. So if I don't know who the friends are.
Because nowadays it's more going on the net. Child talk also on net only. They become friends on net. So it is more important to check it out.
Moms know best.
Moms know best.
Moms know best.
Moms know best.